today we are going to talk about the easiest fall vegetable you could possibly grow in your backyard this season. My name is Kelly, and I am the founder and creator of the Wild Child Garden Club and the Wild Child Kitchen Garden Academy. I coach over 100 gardeners in zones 8 and 9 in South Louisiana, showing them how to take their gardens from underperforming to overproducing. And I love showing people the way. And today, I want to show you how you can start growing your garden in the space you have with the time you've got with this very easy fall vegetable. I'm gonna take it all the way down for you today and show you what's the easiest vegetable you can grow this fall season. Are you ready to dig in? Okay, the easiest fall vegetable there is to grow, hands down, no question, is lettuce. Lettuce is always going to be at the top of my list. I recommend it. You will find lettuce on almost every single one of the Wild Child print and plant garden plans. I don't believe there should be a garden in this world that doesn't have lettuce. Now, it didn't always feel so easy to me. When I first started gardening, I planted all of the leftover stalks from the iceberg lettuce I bought at the grocery store. When we were finished eating it, I would go outside and plant the stalk. Now, did that work? Absolutely not. So did I think to myself that I could be doing something wrong? No, instead, I thought that lettuce was hard to grow. That could not be further from the truth, guys. Lettuce is so simple. It doesn't require much space, it doesn't require much time, and it really will wow you all season long. It's fast growing, it's gorgeous, and it's delicious. And the secret to growing lettuce is simply that you need to choose the right varieties. And if we're being perfectly honest, that's the hardest part because there are so many. There's no shortage of lettuce to get excited about, trust me. Now, you may find that to be a little bit overwhelming. I don't think so. I say pick a few and plant them. See what you like. Let your garden teach you what you want to grow. It's very, very simple and so much fun. Now, I will tell you, when you add lettuce to your garden, it's going to take your garden to the next level. A lot of people don't think about lettuce as an aesthetic to your garden, but I'm going to tell you what. If you're on the Wild Child email list, you got an email from me this morning and I shared some of my favorite varieties. If you would like to get that email or you would like to know some of my favorite varieties, sign up at releaseyourinnerwildchild.com and I'll be happy to send them over to you. This morning, I sent a letter out to my email fam and let them see some of my favorite lettuce varieties. The color in your garden that you will get from lettuce will take it to the next level. You don't realize how much beauty planting lettuce is going to actually add to your backyard garden. I want you to try it for its taste. I want you to try it because it's simple. I want you to try it because it's so good for you. But I want you to try it because it's beautiful. It will take your backyard garden to the next level. Another thing I absolutely love about lettuce is that it grows so fast. If you plant transplants, within just 2 weeks, you'll be cutting lettuce. It's really that fast. If you grow by seed, it'll take about 30 days. So trust me when I tell you, you want some lettuce in your backyard garden. Now, do you want to know how to grow it? I'm going to tell you. First way I love to plant lettuce is I want to make sure I use it to fill in all the spaces that have been left open from the other varieties I have in my garden. I feel like lettuce is just great for this. Almost thinking of it like a ground cover will let you plant so much more, which means you can broaden out and choose some more varieties. It will also allow you to really just get creative. Now, another way that I love to fill in space with lettuce is with my strawberries. Now, if you've ever heard me talk about strawberries, they are like a psycho ex-girlfriend in the garden. They are needy, they are bossy, and they don't like anybody in their territory, except for the months of like November to February when they're sound asleep and they don't know what's going on around them. I say fill in the spaces that your strawberries have left for you with lettuce in these cool season months, and then you will have them right out of your garden by the time the strawberries wake up. That is a great, great way to incorporate lettuce into a bed you may already have that you might think is full. Fill in those spaces. Secondly, plant lettuce on the edge of your beds and in the corners. That's gonna help it get the sun that it needs, but keep in mind, guys, it doesn't mind a little bit of shade. So if it works its way underneath something, that really can be okay if it shades it minimally. But plant it on the edges and in the corners, and it will be a beautiful border for you whenever you walk out into your garden. It's gorgeous. It will also make it super, super easy to pick. And trust me, you're gonna wanna pick it. I love planting lettuce in window boxes. I said it. I like to plant lettuce in window boxes. Sometimes window boxes can be super frustrating. They dry out really quickly. They're difficult. Sometimes they've got a little bit of shade from the roof of the house that keep them from really producing those big, beautiful flowers that you would like. Put some lettuce in a window box. Make sure you water it every day or as it needs it. And I'm telling you, it'll be a gorgeous window box the entire season. You can also plant lettuce in containers, pots, big iron, metal containers. Even I have seen lettuce planted like in a bird bath. You can really plant lettuce just about anywhere. Utilize those pots that you have on your patio that you don't have anything in for the winter months and throw some lettuce in there, guys. If growing lettuce in a container excites you at all, you're gonna wanna join us on Sunday. On Sunday, September 26th, I am giving you a little peek into the Wild Child Garden Club. We are inviting you in to our Sunday Zoom call. Now this Sunday, we're gonna be doing it a little bit different. We call it Salad School, and I'm gonna teach you step by step exactly how to grow lettuce in a container to have salad all season long. Now I am going to also teach you what to plant lettuce with and what to make sure that you are not planting lettuce with. I have a full list of companions for you, and you are gonna walk away from Sunday's class with everything you need to start yourself a salad garden right outside your kitchen window in a container that you probably already have. Join us. The link for you is in the description of this video, and you are welcome to come get a glimpse into the Wild Child Garden Club. Now, this class, Salad School, is completely free, but you do need the link to join. I'm happy to send it over to you. Just click the link in the description. One more thing about lettuce that I want you to remember is that it is not friends with broccoli. So while you're going to be planting it all over your garden, filling in every empty space you can, putting it around the edges and in the corners, you want to make sure that you're not planting that lettuce anywhere near broccoli. This is super important because broccoli is actually toxic. They do not get along. And so it is going to cause issues for your lettuce if it's planted close to broccoli. Again, a lot of times because you don't know these things, we automatically assume that we are just not good gardeners or that lettuce is just hard to grow because we plant it by broccoli and it doesn't do what it's supposed to do. What we don't realize is we just didn't know it doesn't grow well by broccoli. Join us in Salad School. I'm gonna go over all of this with you and I'm gonna show you step by step how to start this salad garden complete with companions and your container. It's gonna be so much fun. You really can grow a salad garden right outside your kitchen window and be harvesting from it in 2 weeks, literally for less than $25. Guys, I'm telling you, the lettuce is where it's at. I wanna also make sure you know that lettuce, while it comes in so many different varieties, and I encourage you to try them all. Try the head lettuce, try romaine, try some butter crunch, but do not forget about those loose leaf varieties. This is where it's at because a loose leaf lettuce is almost, if you think in your head, like a spring mix that you would get from the grocery store. So as you go out and you cut what you need, you leave the rest of the plant and more just grows. Then you go out, you cut what you need, more just grows. Your lettuce is gonna be accessible for you all season long. Whereas with head lettuce or romaine lettuce, you're gonna harvest that all at once, which is gonna leave you with an empty space. Now, of course, you can always add more lettuce to that empty space. Lettuce can be succession planted all throughout the season. And you can plant it actually from seed or transplant. So you can get some packs of seeds if you really want to be creative, or if you just want to play it safe, grab some transplants at your local nursery. I encourage you to just get creative and enjoy starting yourself a salad garden. I really think you will find that you will be so satisfied and blown away by how much you will harvest. One more thing about lettuce that I love, one more thing that shows you how easy it is that it doesn't mind cold weather. So while everything else in the garden needs to be covered in a frost, your lettuce is perfectly fine in a frost. You wouldn't think it, but it is. Most varieties do not mind it one bit. So you're able to just leave it and it just keeps right on growing. It doesn't seem like it wouldn't mind frost, but I'm telling you guys, it doesn't. One more reason that you should be growing lettuce this season. I really hope to see you in Salad School, guys, on Sunday at 4. You can get that link in the description of this video. I'm telling you, we're going to go through step by step. I'm going to give you my favorite varieties. I'm going to tell you how to companion plant, what they love, what they don't love, and we're going to set up our very own container gardens right there inside of Salad School. So you don't want to miss it. Join us in the Wild Child Garden Club. Come in, see what it's all about, and you are going to leave there inspired to start your very own salad garden. And I'm telling you, if you do that, you're going to be one happy gardener all season long. Thank you so much, guys, for joining. I am so glad to spend this half hour with you. If you would like more information, you can visit my website at releaseyourinnerwildchild.com. You can join the mailing list there. You can also get our Wild Child Print and Plant garden plans for fall and our fall companion planting guide. This is all super good information, and it's all on our website, releaseyourinnerwildchild.com. Thanks so much for joining, and I'll see y'all next time.